Can you see the video screen?
Yes, sir.
Hello. We can.
Yeah, yeah. So in this video, there are two wind turbine. The one above is the new design, which we name it cross-axis wind turbine. And the lower one is in the this video is the typical VAWT. Both of them look similar, but the new design will replace the supporting, the two layer of supporting hub with something like a horizontal wind turbine rotor. So if we manage to bring the air from the bottom, the air deflected, the parallel or the horizontal air, when it reached the deflector, the air was reflected. The deflected air will act to the horizontal blade, whereas the undisturbed air will act on the vertical blade. So we within the same space or volume, we try to double the wind turbine blade area. By doing so, we hope that the output will be increased significantly. So let's see this video. You can see the turbine above, the cross-axis turbine, able to self-start faster than this typical horizontal axis wind turbine. Are we back to the PowerPoint slide on the potential application?
So, yes, sir. Solution and customer benefits.
Yeah, yeah. So, here's number one, the cross-axis wind turbine on high-rise building. This is the very initial idea when we try to integrate this new invention. The design that able to capture the wind from both directions. Like I say, the vertical blade capture the undisturbed wind speed, whereas the horizontal blade, it looked like a supporting structure in the arrangement, but we replace the normal strut with the aerofoil blade. The horizontal blade will capture the airflow that hit the building facade and move up as an upward draft. Okay, and see the diagram. Seem able to capture more airflow. I'm not sure this is. I think we are okay. You know, without any additional structure, without we use the original structure, which is the building. Cleverly. Capitalize the deflected flow and the original flow to maximize the power. But this small wind turbine potential is not that huge. Okay? In terms of market, small wind turbine is still small. The bigger or the major share in the market for wind turbine is the offshore wind turbine, which is increasing in terms of capacity installed. And when we look into this specific application, it feels like the cross-axis wind turbine design together with the deflector. The bottom part that you can see with some fin, a shroud, it should be able to outperform the current horizontal and vertical type wind turbine based on the advantages and disadvantages that we mentioned just now. Okay. If we compare to HAWT, the CAWT, which take the general configuration of VAWT, do not require the yaw mechanism. And compared to HAWT, the important part are mounted near to the water surface, which make it easy for installation work and maintenance work. The center of gravity is low compared to HAWT, which is not stable. And you can see for the HAWT, when all the heavy part are mounted on top of the tower, which is about 100 to 150 meter height, it create two moment. One is near to the water surface, the floating platform. Another bigger moment come from the heavy component on top of the wind tower. So these two moment make the design of the foundation very complicated. And also safety issue become a major concern, especially when the sea is very rough. For the VAWT, it's quite clear that the component is less and the heavy component are mounted near to the water surface. It can collect wind from all directions without requiring a yawing mechanism. So it saves one mechanism. Saving one moving assembly mean less possibility for fuel failure and maintenance. But the problem of the VAWT is the performance and difficult to self-start. So if our CAWT are able to overcome the two major drawbacks of VAWT, it will make this design superior by combining the advantage of two category of HAWT and VAWT. So other potential application is mounting the small wind turbine near to the edge of building corner as integrated with the sideboard, using the sideboard as a deflector to enhance the performance of wind turbine. You can see this artist impression. It creates a synergetic effect with the billboard, large billboard. So the flat surface of the billboard act like a deflector to deflect the wind and speed up the wind before it interact with wind turbine blade. And wind turbine itself as a rotating object, it will enhance the advertising effect. So the rotating turbine become an eye-catching object that attract more attention to enhance the advertising effect. It can also generate small amount of energy to be used for lighting, to light up the billboard during nighttime. I think that's all. I think we go a bit far, huh?